For the 389.
Well, fuck it. I said hell with it, man. I'm gonna do this one. So, got my Peterbilt 389, fucking custom truck, and got the skin off the workshop. So the monster trailer with my black and green truck. This is gonna be nice. This is gonna be one hell of a haul. Oh, let's start it out, I guess. Don't bust this trailer up, man. This is a $98,000 load. This is a $98,000 load, man. This is a fucking... This is the king fucking load here. This is the load that'll make you quiver. This is the load that'll make you quiver. And I'm going out this way. So I'm going out this way. Yeah, this way. I'm gonna have to make this extra wide. Oh, incoming traffic on the other lane. I didn't want to do that, but hell. Nobody coming, I guess. No harm, no foul. And it's another Arch Nemesis 623 special. $98,000 trailer on top of the boot. Jeez. I guess going to level 25 does pay off for you. And I just filled up, so I'm pretty much good to go on fuel. Well, somewhat. I gotta get out of this town, dude. This shit's lagging. Fuck. Yeah, I don't think this... this trailer is fucking massive, dude. Fucking massive. Holy shit. Well. Trucking simulator video. Hell. Can I say another trucking simulator? Trucking simulator. God, love it. So... So they didn't have nothing in the workshop for any skins or nothing?
They might.
Oh, speeding a little bit. Oh, I don't know. I was just seeing if they did. Oh, that was freaky. Yeah, oh man, it's gonna be one hell of a journey, dude. I had to drive 14 hours just to go up here and get this load, hook up to it. Now I gotta drive another 17 hours on top of the boot to drive it out of here. Isn't that crazy though? Man, that's just fucked up, dude. How would you drive 14 hour drive just to go up and get a $98,000 load? And then have to drive another 17 hours on top of it to drive it to its destination. That's like almost 30 fucking hours. That's over 30 fucking hours. That's like over 30 fucking hours of driving that I'm gonna have to do. And to mention only right now, I'm only going, I gotta go 55 miles an hour because the speed limit is 55 in California. Jeez. Did you guys ever hear of a gas pedal? But we Californians, man, party on, dude, man, tubular, man. We live the rich life, man. Beverly Hills 90210 shit, man. We live in the Playboy mansions. We got a mansion on every fucking, on every block. Fuck, who cares about driving 70 miles an hour on the road? Or 60 miles an hour or whatever. 55, man, is the speed limit, dude. Fucking California, man. Gotta beat it. The only place you can go get a tan, go surfing, and fucking drive 55 miles on the fucking road. On the highway. 55 on a highway, really? Fuck. The hell with me, man. Boring, boring, boring. 56 miles. But I gotta admit though, putting this, I don't know about the black and green, the flames, and then having the blue dashboards in it. I don't know, I'm thinking about changing those out to the regular dashboards. To the other dashboards I had in. This dashboard looks pretty cool, the green in it, but, or the blue, but it's like a light blue. It's not like a dark blue, it's like a lightish blue. But. Hey, Fruit Loops truck. Yay, Fruit Loops. Yeah, like I said, all those mods that I put in there today, the real-time fucking shit, that shit does really good, man. That, real businesses, like you have the, Walmart and FedEx and UPS. Shit makes it actually look better. You know, U-Haul instead of U-Tool, or U-Hool, and, you know, UPS is not UDS. Freight job. Freight job. Please pull into the weigh station. Have a good fucking Merry Christmas. Fucking Hanukkah and Merry Christmas to you too. Assholes. Yeah, you see that cop right there? Yeah, he's just waiting to bust you as soon as you go over 15 miles an hour. Pig. Fucking eat some donuts, you fucking. Go fucking eat a Twinkie, you bitch. Probably sitting in his fucking car eating a Twinkie or something. Nom 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 Twinkies. Nom. Nom 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 Twinkies.
What are you eating? I'm eating a Twinkie. What are you eating? I'm eating a ho-ho. Because you are a yo-yo.
Ah, I love it. Fudge.
You want some Dunkin' Donuts to go with that Twinkie, motherfucker?
Ah, fucking cops. Gotta love them.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you like my lights on my car, my truck? Don't look good. Oh, up speed a little bit. Uh-oh, up speeding. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, I'm speeding a little bit. Don't do that, you'll get a ticket. Don't do that, you'll get a ticket. Uh-oh, I'll get a ticket for speeding. The cop might put his donut and his ho-ho down and might come after me. He might fucking go run for the border and get some Dunkin' Donuts. Oh no, a fat pig might fucking come and get me. Oh, I'm so scared, man. I'm shaking in my boots. So all you gotta do is, man, when a cop comes by you, is just throw a box of Twinkies out there on his car. He'll be alright. It'll be alright. Just don't give me a ticket. Here's the Twinkies. You can have them. Here's the Ding Dongs. You can have them. Just don't give me a ticket. Here's Dunkin' Donuts. Here's your fucking double latte fucking coffee. Oh, shit. Double mint. Fucking trailer. Oh, shit. Oh. No, that's funny. I gotta quit making fun of cops because they're actually good. I gotta quit making fun of them. That's not fair. Still 55 through here. Jesus. Oh, that's not because I'm not out of California yet. Oh. Yeah, this Peterbilt 389 is not bad. I mean, I'm glad they put it in the game. It's like over a year before they put this in there. Like the Kenworth W900 was the first one to put in here. And then after a year, they finally put this one in here. Well, I gotta admit, it's a smooth running truck though. It's not really bad. But I'm so used to the W900, but now that I own my company, and I've got three drivers, so got a little money to play with, level 25. Can I get out of California anytime soon? Stockton. Jesus, still got a long way to go. Can a motherfucker get out of California, please? Well, I'm glad I filled up, by the way. I can't believe that, being that it's the 389, that they didn't have the 625 horsepower engine in it. You would think that they would have it since the W900 had it.
You'd think?
Yeah, you would think, because when they put the W900 in the game, they put the fucking... They put the 625 horsepower engine motor in it. That's the last engine you unlock for the W900, and you would think the 389, you would think they would put the 625 motor in it, but they only gave you the 550. The 550 is the highest they give you. They don't give you the 625. You would think they would put the 625 in here for this. I've got so many mods downloaded for this fucking game. All the trailer mods.
Oh, this motherfucker couldn't find a job.
Ooh, that's gonna cost ya. That's gonna cost ya!
$297 for maintenance and fuel. Oh. Fucking asshole.
Yeah, they will cost ya.
When your motherfucker keeps that shit up, I'm gonna fucking boot him to the fucking corner.
Yeah, when they don't,
That fucking crackhead that's over here.
Yeah, when you hire your drivers and they can't find a job or nothing, it'll cost you fucking maintenance and fuel. That's one of the drawbacks to owning your company. Like, right now I've got 3 drivers, and 2 of them brought back no money. When they can't find a job, it takes away the maintenance and fuel cost. Takes away the maintenance and fuel cost. So it actually deducts like $500-$600 from your account. So it's like $500-$600.
Yeah, he keeps doing that, he's gonna get fucked.
So it's like $500-$600 that you're actually losing out on your business. Oh. What the hell was that? What the hell was that? The hell just hit me? Fuck, just hit me. Don't look all that bad. That monster trailer. That trailer don't look all that bad on my truck. It's kind of neat. It's kind of neat having that monster trailer on my truck. But I'm driving in third person because I'm trying to look at the trailer. I want to look at the trailer real quick. Kind of neat looking at it. Even though I'm not used to driving in third person. Even though it's a pain in the ass. Driving third person is like a fucking challenge. You got all these viaduct bridges and shit, but not looking too bad. Whoop, sorry buddy. My bad. But ain't too bad. I mean, $98,000 job though, but I mean, I had to go fucking 14 hours to pick it up, but I guess for the most part it'd be alright. Like I said, you know, this game, man, I remember this game when it first came out. Like, I played this game when it first came out, man, and they didn't have shit. I mean, you started out with nothing. Yeah, 2 fucking cities. Yeah, California and Nevada, or
now you know what Nevada. This would be really badass if they would have done to this game now? Is have the officers actually come up behind vehicles and shit and light them up and make them pull over and shit.
Yeah, you know they're not gonna do that though. That's too complicated for them to do. That's too complicated.
I was just watching this cop ride this trucker's ass. I'm like, that'd be funny if that motherfucker just lit that bitch up.
Oh, lit his lights up? Yeah. Yeah, it would be funny to see. That kind of would be funny to see. I kind of like to see that. But, here we go. So, what you taking in now, load?
I found, gifts.
Ooh.
79,000.
Damn. Not bad. Not bad. It's good. It's not bad. I mean, it's not great, but it's not bad either. I mean,
so. All I done so far, all internal contracts. I ain't done no fucking freight shit.
You want to know something? Long distance, put it all the way up. It fucking works out, though. Long distance, man. You put your points in long distance. But see, the thing is, like I told you, you gotta measure out your long distance with your fuel economy. If you have 3 in long distance, you have to have 3 in fuel economy. You can't have like 4 in like 3 in long distance and like 1 in fucking fuel economy, because you ain't gonna work. You're gonna be fucking going at the pump every 20 seconds. You know, you're gonna be filling up every fucking 20 minutes. Because your fucking car, your truck is gonna suck gas, where when your fuel economy's up, you're gonna be sipping on the gas. You're not gonna make as many trips to the pump. Like right now, this is a 17-hour contract, and I just filled up full tank just before I got to my contract. Just before I picked up the trailer, and I just basically broke the F. Like, I'm just coming off the F right now. And I still have 8 hours left to do on this. I still have 8 more hours left to do on this run. I still have 8 more hours left. So. It's not bad. I mean, 8-hour run. I mean, it's a 17-hour run. But, like I said, I had to go 14 hours, drive all the way up to Redding from San Diego all the way to Reddington to pick it up, and then drive from there all the way back down here. So I actually had to drive all the way from San Diego, or not San Diego, but something like that, San Diego or something. I had to drive like all the way, like one of those ones all the way down at the end. Let me see, I can tell you where I had to drive from. I literally had to drive from, San Diego, from San Diego, California, all the way up to Reddington, to pick this load up, and now I gotta go all the way back down from Reddington, all the way back down to San Diego. So basically I just went from San Diego all the way up to Reddington to pick it up, and then from Reddington back down to San Diego to drop it off. So basically I just did a 17-hour trip, a 14-hour trip, and a 17-hour trip. So I don't know how they figured that out, because I spent 14 hours going up there and getting it, and then now I gotta spend 17 hours coming back. So I don't know how they figured that out, but. Yeah, but hell. But I guess that's where it goes. So, got 8 more hours on this contract, so gonna be a little long haul. And it's getting nighttime, so yay, nighttime, night driving. Yay. In California, double yay. Kudos, yay, high fives for everybody. We're going to nighttime. You know what I noticed at this map?
I think I'm going to Nevada, I think.
I don't know why they made me go from San Diego all the way up to Reddington, from Reddington back down to San Diego. So I just basically did a big fucking loop. Please pull into the weigh station, the nearest weigh station. Thank you for your...
Damn, wonders. I got Carlsbad I didn't get yet. Oxnard I haven't had yet. Santa Maria I haven't got. Eureka I haven't got. And Hornbrook I haven't got yet. Shit, most of... What is it? 38.99% explored.
Station down. So now I can go back on the road again and actually do shit. Brakes on, brakes off.
I altered my course to try to get some of these roads I ain't got discovered yet. Hopefully it don't fuck me up.
Like I said, when you, the more towns that you discover, the more fucking contracts will open up in them towns for you. Like the more contracts, like that's why it's always good when you first start off playing this game is to go down and open up as many fuck as many cities as you can. Like when you first start in the game, the first thing you want to do is you want to try to get contracts that you haven't opened up, cities that you haven't opened up yet. Like if you take a contract that's in like Reddington and you take another contract that's in Reddington, you really don't want to do it. You want to take a contract that's in like something else like San Diego, somewhere you haven't discovered yet, and take a contract out of there, or take a contract to there so you can discover that city, because the more cities you discover, the more fucking, believe it or not, each city has its own fucking contracts or has its own shit. The more cities you open up, the more contracts and the more fucking jobs you'll get. So, the less cities you have opened up, the less fucking contracts you're gonna get. Which, I don't know why they do it like that, but I can see how. I mean, but some cities won't even have much contracts. They'll have, like, 2-3 contracts. And they'll be, like, fucking, like, 10,000. When you go to another, like, a major... When you go to a major city, and you get a contract, you're getting, like, you're getting a $70,000 contract versus, you know, going to fucking California or going to L.A., you know, Los Angeles. Getting a contract out of Los Angeles, you're looking at around 80, 60,000. But yet you go up to Reddington or Truckee, and you're probably looking at a contract that's probably worth like 16,000 or 20,000. So it varies with city. But the more cities you open up, the more contracts will come open. Like when you go through your pages for your contracts, you'll have more pages. You'll have more cities open up. So that's why they always say it's always good to do that. But for me, that's the first thing I did. But yeah, I don't know what the road explorer is, because actually I had like 90% of the roads explored. And when they scaled the map up or whatever, down or whatever, how they scaled it, when they scaled it, it took all my progress back down to map explorer or roads explorer, took me back down to zero again. And I had like fucking like 80 some percent of the roads explored. Like I had all the yellow fucking, like I had all the yellow, like all the roads were yellow, they weren't gray. Like I had like 80 some percent of it explored. And then they scaled the map, of course. They did an update and they scaled the map. They scaled the map up some to make it bigger. And of course, now I gotta do it all over again. Why don't you just take my trophies too while you're at it? But, eh, oh well. It's always fun exploring the map again. At least they didn't make you explore each. At least they didn't make you explore each city again. So that's a good thing. At least they didn't make you like start over, having to explore all the cities and open up all the cities. But this is grueling. 55 miles an hour, man. I'm wanting to go 65 and 75 and 80. Shit, Arizona, you can go 80 and shit. And Nevada, you can go 75, 65. California, it's 55, it's 55. Kind of a bummer. Hey, look, anime truck. Ah, jeez, push that, push it up the hill. Ah, damn. Push this sucker up a hill. Jeez. It's night driving.
Put on them goddamn brakes.
Night driving.
That was my bad on that one. I wasn't even paying the fuck attention to that shit. Damn near missed my turn.
No, you don't want to do that. Definitely don't want to do that. Because then you have to double back and circle around. Oh, you hear that fuck? You hear that retarder kicking in? Slowing my truck down. Down an incline hill. Ah, you gotta love night driving. Isn't it fun?
Healthcare center. Okay.
Whatever floats your boat, dude. Yeah, I like the fucking... I don't know, man. I may keep the blue gauges. This blue interior looks pretty cool. But I got a green truck, so that don't really look all that good. Might have to find a green... Might have to go back to the green interior again. Might have to go back to the green, to the green dials. Trying to match everything that goes along with the green truck, so the black and green.
Thinking about going back to my 389. I don't know, I just every time, man, I want to drive something else and I always go back to the 389, dude.
Yeah, I know. Ain't it so? So I'm driving right now to 389. I'm kind of liking this 389. I've driven the W900, the Kenworth W900 since level 10, and I was level 23 when I gave it up to my other driver to drive. Because I gave it to my other driver to drive, and I bought this truck fully customized out and everything else for this 389. So if I ever want to drive my W900, all I got to do is give this to my driver and take that one back. So I don't know, I mean, the newer fucking, the 680s and stuff, I mean, they're fun to drive, but they're just, I don't know, just something about them I just don't like. I just like driving the older trucks. It's just something about the newer trucks I really don't like. It's not the interior or nothing like that, it's just, I don't know, driving the newer trucks, it's like, eh. Turn radius is real good on them, though. I mean, really good turn radius. The T680s, I mean, they have some really good turn radius. I mean, you could turn on a dime on that sucker, where the bigger trucks, they don't have that big turn radius. So when you're trying to turn sharp turns with a older truck, with the 389s and the W900s, you're not going to do the sharp turn radius, where the newer car, where the 680s and the 570s and all that, you can do that sharp turn radius. Where these older ones, you can't do the sharp turn radius. You got to make a wide. They got a wide turn radius. So you almost got to slow down to like 10 miles an hour just to turn. Just to turn sharply with it. I mean, you could turn sharply with it, but you're not going to be going no fucking... no 15 miles an hour turning sharply with it. You're going to be going like 3 miles an hour to turn sharply with this truck. Like, you're going to be creeping at 3 miles an hour.
Hey, just, Nevada.
You know. Yeah, I'm coming up on Los Angeles to San Diego. Yay.
It's the first time I've been in fucking Nevada in a long time.
Hmm. I've been around California. I haven't left California yet. But I couldn't pass up on this $98,000 job, though. Even though I had to go 14 hours to go up and get it. And then 17 hours to drive it back. I mean, that's worth it, I guess. I mean, I don't know. Depends on what XPs I get. We'll find out, because I'm getting ready to go on to San Diego. So my exit's coming up here pretty soon. So we'll find out. Just, I'm hoping it's going to be worth it, because I just drove 14 hours up there and 17 hours back. So I'm just hoping I didn't waste my time driving 14 hours to go up there and get the load. San Diego, California. I mean, it was a nice drive, though. Going all the way up to from San Diego to Reddington, and then Reddington to San Diego, back down to San Diego. So I basically just went the same way that I came up, that I came back down. So it's kind of neat. I've never done that before. I've never went up to, like, Reddington to pick up or something like that. Like, go up to a town to pick something up and then come back down from the town that you just came from. So it's kind of neat doing it. Plus, not to mention my... I had my 43 profile that got deleted, or I reformatted my computer and forgot to save my save data, so now I'm starting over. Yay. Always fun to start over. But I made a lot of newbie mistakes, too, in my old profile. Like, I started my business too big, hired too many drivers really too quick. Just, I did a lot of, like, my points, I didn't put them in the way I should have. I put them in stupidly, so I was kind of like uneven and outbalanced, not balanced, but uneven out my points. So, actually, to tell you the truth, doing it over again, having this data and having to start my game over again, actually, a lot of the mistakes that I made in my first save data, actually, you know, now I, because when I first started playing the game, you forgot, I didn't know nothing about the game, so I was all new at everything. You know, hiring drivers, firing drivers, souping their, you know, modding out their vehicles, you know, all that shit I didn't know about. So I was just playing it by ear, and I was messing up. So, you know, I had like three fucking garages and like 15 drivers and 15 trucks, and it was just a clusterfuck mess. So it was actually good that it did corrupt my data, and I had to start over. Because now I'm not making all those newbie mistakes that I made, that a noob would actually make. Like, say somebody would just start playing this game, they'd probably make all kinds of mistakes.
That was just a practice run anyway.
Right. Your very first save data is just a practice run just to learn how to play the game. Then you get it corrupted. Then you get it deleted out of your computer. Then you start over fresh. And then this one is your good one. This is the one that actually counts. That one's just a dummy profile. Your first save data is always a dummy profile. It doesn't mean nothing. You can go ahead and just blow all your money and do whatever you want. But I actually did make a lot of newbie mistakes, though. I actually did. Because I put my points in differently. I didn't put my points in. I didn't even out my points like I was supposed to. I started hiring drivers. Like, I hired like 5 drivers right off the rip. You know, I fully customized my garage out, and I just hired like 5 drivers and bought like 5 trucks right off the rip. It was a cluster hell. But I was a noob, so I didn't really know none at that point. Playing this game was new to me. Well, playing simulator games were new to me too, so. Because I played Farming Simulator 15, and now I play Farming Simulator 17 in this one, so. You're the one that actually got me into playing these fucking simulator games. Never used to play these things. Like, I could not give a care in the world about these simulator games. You couldn't even get me to play a simulator game. Till your dumbass made me get Farming Simulator 15. But hey. But hey, simulator games are actually fun. A lot of people don't think they are, but they actually are fun to play. A lot of people knock simulator games like, oh man, there's just too many button pushing, and oh my god, you gotta push this button, you gotta push that button, you gotta push this button, you gotta do this, you gotta lift this down, you gotta lift this up, you gotta detach this, you gotta detach that. It's like a lot of fucking button pushing, but it's actually basically like right now, just this game is like driving basically a truck like you would be driving in real life. It's just...
Yep, it is.
It's just basically, you know, for people that don't, that can't, that, you know, it's for people that can never drive a truck. Like, somebody who can never get a CDL license or drive a truck, they can actually buy the game here and actually act like they're a trucker and actually play as being a trucker. And it simulates basically a real truck. So... basically not all that bad. I thought it was going to be worse than this, so. Whoa.
Yeah, it turned out to be a pretty nice game.
Yeah, it did. I mean, they did a really good job on this game. I mean, to me, the graphics is really good. Like, I mean, but like they said, they used the Google map to make the maps for this game anyways. Like, everything that is in here is in real life. Like, all the exits, all the off and on ramps, all the fucking bypass, viaducts, the lamppost. The only thing they didn't put in there was all the fucking buildings and stuff, but, you know that. They can't get everything right. But, for the most part, it's basically based on, basically, like, right now, if you were driving this, this would be what California would be right now. The highways and getting on and getting off the highways. So it's actually neat that they actually use Google Map to actually make this game, to actually make the maps for this game. But I'm at my destination. Yay, balloons on top. Supermarket. Walmart. Taking a Monster Energy drink. Fucking 98,000 fucking KJAB. Now this is gonna be a bitch, cause I got this big ass fucking monster truck, monster drink, fucking monster energy drink, fucking trailer. This is gonna be a bitch pulling in, man. Ah, Jesus, this is gonna be a bitch pulling in. Oh my god, this is gonna be a bitch. This is gonna be a whore bag. This fucking long ass, lanky ass truck.
I gotta find out a fucking auto centering on this fucking piece of shit. Properties. Yeah. Game settings. Auto centering settings. By the wheel.
389's not doing bad though. It's holding in there. Not centered.
Oh shit, I just rear-ended somebody.
Not centered. I can get the parking bonus for the centering. Ooh, I did get it. Yay. Oh, that concludes this one. $98,000 job. Holy cow. And I got excellent. Damn, 98,000. Wee. Not much XP though. Well, that's just because I'm level 25 going at 26, so. That's not gonna happen. Oh.
I just jacked the rear end of
little arch nemesis 623. Not a fucking load.
Huh?
Said I just rear-ended a semi.